how we can use continuous assignment to instantiate buses, wider width buses. How are we instantiating a tri-state buffer, a one-bit tri-state buffer using gate level modeling? Which keyword did we use to instantiate tri-state buffer?
Buffif 1 or Buffif 0.
So, okay, these were the keywords that were used to instantiate tri-state buffers. Now, if you remember, all of these tri-state buffers instantiated were of single bit. Now, if you want to instantiate a multi-bit tri-state buffer, you can use assign keyword, and you use the same conditional expression, with the exception. In the conditional expression, first there was a true expression, then there is a false expression. Now, if you look at this assign bus, if you look at this statement, assign bus. Now, bus is on the left hand side. Okay, what should be the data type of bus? Net. Okay, let's assume that the size of the bus, let's assume if we define the size of the bus, let's assume we are defining output 31, 0 bus. So now what is the size of the bus in this particular example? 32 bit. Okay, now the bus on the left hand side is of 32 bits. Now on the right hand side, if you look at that right hand side, select is a true expression because we are using conditional expression. When it's a true expression, this select line is 1 bit. And since we are using conditional expression, the signal A should be of how many bits?
32 bits.
It should also be 32 bits. Now it's a true expression or false expression? True expression. Okay, so this is equivalent to buffif 1 or buffif 0?
Buffif
1. This is equivalent to buffif 1 because the select line is active high or active low? Active high. Let's assume if you want to enable an active low signal, then what should we do? No, in this expression, tilde. We can either use tilde because tilde is for one bit. Okay, tilde A, so then it will be active low. So now this 32 bit A, this 32 bit A is true expression or false expression? So if the condition is true, what will be assigned to bus A? If the condition is false, so the output will be high impedance. Now if you look at this, how many tri-state buffer will be input? How many tri-state buffers?
32.
Because the size is 32 bits, so 32 tri-state buffers will be input. One for the most significant bit, then for the next most significant bit, and in so far so on until the least significant bit. So if you look at the first expression that is highlighted in yellow, in the first expression, what will be assigned in hardware or what will be instantiated in hardware? So actually it will be tri-state buffer. This is a pictorial representation of tri-state buffer. What will go on the select line? Cell 1. What will go on the output? Bus. What is the size of the bus? So how we can write? 31, 0. What should be on the input? A. What is the size of A? 31, 0. So if you look at this, one tri-state buffer. Now it is one tri-state buffer. Now, if you look at the second statement, assign bus. Again, a tri-state buffer will be input. I'm highlighting this in another color. What is your select line?
Cell 2.
What is your output? bus. What is the size of bus? 31, 0, it is 32 bit signal. What should be on the input?
B.
Now what should we do now? Because now look at the third statement. Look at the third statement. I'm highlighting this in green color. So similarly, cell 3 will go here. Bus is your output for the third statement. 31, 0. Okay, and what should be on the input? C, 31, 0. Now since bus is of the same name, so what will we do now? We will connect all of them together. So this bus will be connected together. So now we instantiated a bus. We instantiated a bus. How many devices are connected to the bus? Three devices. What is the name of the device? D1, D2 and D3. Actually, now which device will gain control of the bus will determine by the signal cell 1, cell 2 and cell 3. And the controller should ensure, that only one device is active at a time. No two devices should be allowed to drive the bus at the same time. Now if you look, this one tri-state buffer. This is a pictorial representation of a tri-state buffer. It is a 32-bit tri-state buffer. But if you look at each individual tri-state, how many tri-state buffer will be inferred? If you look at this tri-state buffer, 32 individual tri-state buffer will be inferred. So actually, how will it look like? Now you will have first tri-state buffer. Actually, tri-state buffer is 1 bit. So what will go on the select line? Cell? Or is it in A31? What should be your output?
Bus
31. If you look at only one this tri-state buffer, then again it will go on so far so on, and then you will have A0. What will go on the select line? Cell 1, sorry. And then and this bus 31 will connect to the bus 31 again, another tri-state buffer. And on the input of the tri-state buffer, there will be B31. Then there will be another tri-state buffer, C31. So in this way. So the designer must ensure, whenever you want to instantiate any tri-state buffers, you must ensure that cell 1, cell 2 and cell 3, only one signal should be enabled at a time. Because bus is a shared resource. In microcontroller or microprocessor, bus is a shared resource, and if you want to connect multiple devices to the bus, every device has an enabled signal. Device A is enabled by which signal?
Cell 1.
Device B? Cell 2. And device C? Cell 3. So each device has its own enabled signal, and designer will ensure that only what? Is one device is connected to the bus. Now, if you want to instantiate a priority encoder, you may have studied this in DLD. What's a priority encoder?
Priority
encoder. I will explain this with an example. Now, let's assume if you all of students are sitting in the class, okay, our students are sitting in the class, and one is CR and another other students. Actually, I give priority to CR. So if CR will raise hand, I will service him. If two or three students have raised their hand and CR has raised their hand, to which student I will give the priority? To CR. So let's assume if we have a hierarchy in the university. So let's assume we have a dean and HOD and a teacher. So actually, who should be prioritized? Dean, because he is highest in the level. So actually, in a priority-based system or priority-based architecture, actually the device which has got the highest priority, which gets service first. If you remember in interrupt-driven I/O, if you remember, okay. So actually there were interrupts. And if we say that, okay, there are three devices and they are connected to the microprocessor, okay, and two devices have generated an interrupt. So which device will we get service? We'll get service. The one with the highest priority should get the service first, and then followed by the device that has the least priority. So now, like, so if we want to prioritize different devices, okay, prioritize different device. So if you look at this truth table, okay, which device has got the highest priority? A has got the highest priority. Why A has got the highest priority? If A is one, cell one is one. So actually, A is enabled by cell one. So if cell one is one, whatever, if cell two is, it means the cell one is one, it means that A has generated an interrupt. It wants a service. Device A has wants a service. So okay, I will explain this with an example, and with more, I will elaborate it more here. So now let's assume a scenario. We have a truth table. Now we have cell A, cell B, and then cell C, okay, and then out. Now if cell A is one, so what should be on the output? A. And it's don't care. B and C is don't care. Even let's assume if cell A is one, cell B is one, and cell C is one, what does it imply? All of these devices wants a service. But which device should get the service? A. Now B is next in the priority list. Now cell A is zero. It means cell A does not want the service. So now which device should be given the priority? B. So what? Then A, one? Don't care. Which device should we get? B. And what about 0, 0, 1, C. And if all of them are 0, then D. D has got the least priority, which means, because which devices has got the highest priority? A, C. Okay, now, if you look at this hardware, so how can we decide? Can we decide it like this? Let's assume we have an output. That is your out. Out can be an n bit signal. A, B, C, and D. And out are an n bit signal. And can be any n bit signal. So I'm not just mentioning the sizes of this signal. Okay, out. Out is an n bit signal. So it means that if cell A is one, cell A is one, which signal will go on the output? A. Now, if cell A is zero, so now we can say B or C or D. Now we need another multiplexer. Cell B. If cell B is one, what should go on output? B. 0. C or D. Now again we need another multiplexer. If cell C is 1. C and cell C is 0. D. How can you write the Verilog code for this? So what you can define some intermediate signal. Now there are two methods. I told you there are two methods. Let's assume the method first was, let's assume this is K, this is M. So it's very simple. Assign out is equal to, cell A, question mark, A, semicolon, K. K. Now K is case. Then again, assign K is equal to cell B, question mark, B, M. Again, then assign cell C, sorry, assign M is equal to cell C, question mark C, D. So you can have three different assignments, but then you have to define K and M as
wires.
You should define K and M as wires. But if I want to write it in a single statement, how can I write it? In a single statement, just like, now there are two methods. First is using multi statement. It's up to you that whether you use multi statement or single statement. So if you want to use a single statement, how we can use it? Anybody?
Nested
is condition statement. So actually I can write it like this. Assign out is equal to, what is this out? Yes, out. Assign out is equal to, now which condition? Cell A. So what should be the size of A, cell A? What should be the size of cell A? 1 bit. So if cell A is true, A. If cell is true, then A or we don't know. Now in here we will have
cell B.
If it's true, then B. Otherwise, another statement. Then again, cell C. Now if you look at this, I will explain this. If we say cell A, please, if you have any question, I'm now again explaining it. If cell A is 1, cell A is 1, A, otherwise, it is equal to K. If it is false, then K. Now if you look at it within the K, if cell B is equal to 1, B, otherwise, M. So can I write it like this, M here, and within M you can see here. So now we have instantiated a priority encoder using continuous assignment. Okay, I will request every student to please go home and try this at least once. Just think it, then just draw the truth table and just. No, I will ask this in the quiz. Okay, so now what is the difference? Now, the question is very important. What's the difference between Verilog and other high level languages? The example of high level language is C, C++. Okay, C, C++.
Sir,
C++
is low level language, C. High level
language is C#. Low level language is assembly languages. So in the categorization, now you can further categorize the high level language to very, very high level language or then lower high level. Like you can, there are some gray areas. So, okay, one with the highest higher level language and then with the lowest level language. Okay, so equally C will be classified as high level if you compare it with assembly. Now it's also depends upon your point of comparison. What's your height?
5'11".
No. If I say minus 3, am I right? It can be minus. Now, what's your reference? If your reference is your ground, your height is, let's assume my height is 5. But if my reference is my ceiling, it will be minus 8. So, let's assume if you want to perform a compare two different quantities, then if you compare between assembly and C, you can say, okay, C is a high level language. Yes. And C. Now, if you compare C sharp, and see, then you can say, okay, now it's higher and it's lower. So now it's a comparative analysis. Okay, I think you got my point. Okay, now if you say, what's the difference between Verilog and other high level language? In Verilog, the order does not matter. The order of the statement does not matter. So if you change the order, so the output will be same. But in C or C++, the order does matter. The order matters on the latency and order matter on the performance. I will explain this with an example. Now let's assume. Let's assume if you have this statement, can you see on the left hand side? Just forget about this because we have not studied this. It is actually behavioral modeling, but this is one statement of behavioral modeling. We will study this in more detail later on. But if you say that if you want to instantiate an 8-to-1 multiplexer, if you want to instantiate 8-to-1 multiplexer, so what should be the size of the select line? 3 bits. Okay, so now we are checking the value of select line. If cell is equal to 000, output will be in 1. Else if cell is equal to 1, output will be in 2, and so forth, so on. And then in the last statement, so what will it infer in hardware? Multiplexer. It will infer a multiplexer. And if you look at the gate level, there will be some gates and transistor, finally, and gates and transistor. But now, let's assume if we are looking at this from the high level language perspective. If we have the same statement in C language, so what if the first statement, if cell is equal to 000, the C will check the first statement. Yes. If it's true, then it will check the second statement. If it's true, if the first statement is true, it will not go on the second statement. But if the first condition is false, then it will check the second statement. If it's true, then okay, it will execute the statement. Otherwise, it will check the third statement. So the latency, so let's assume the checking of this, let's assume the latency of here, the latency of checking one statement is 3 cycles. So if the first condition is true, how many cycles will be incurred? 3. If the first condition is false and we want to check the second condition, how many latency? 6. If the third condition? 9. And if the last condition, because there are 8 conditions. 24. Yes, actually, so the latency will be determined by the order. But if you think in terms of hardware, in hardware, what will be inferred? Multiplexer. And multiplexer contains what? Gates. When multiplexer contains gates, so actually it will, the multiplexer will have a delay, and this delay will be fixed or variable.
Yes.
This delay will be fixed or variable. I'm asking this question. This delay will be fixed. Now if you say, if I'm writing code like this, if, let's assume, cell is equal to 5, out is equal to in 6. Else if cell is equal to 0, out is equal to in 1. Now if you look at in this statement, let's assume if cell is equal to 0, what will be the latency for this statement? 6. Assuming that for checking we have a latency of 3. So the first condition is false, second condition is true. What will be the latency here? 6 cycles. Let's assume if you are executing any instruction, if you see the C++ language, it will translate it in assembly. So you are using compare instruction. Compare destination and source. So if you are comparing, so actually some latency will be incurred. Compare, let's assume R3 with 0. Now you want to check with 0. So now this is an instruction. And an instruction has different phases. Instruction first state, instruction decode stage. Then operand phase, I have told you all. So let's assume the execution of this instruction takes 3 cycles. Just an example, okay, how many cycles? It depends on the architecture. In some architecture, it may take 3 cycles. In some architecture, it may take 5 cycles. And it also depends on the architecture. If the processor is pipeline, I'm not going into much details here, but just to give you an idea that let's assume if the condition is satisfied first, and if the condition is satisfied last, in the last. Okay, so now if this condition is not satisfied, you have again a compare instruction. This condition is not, so if you have more comparison, latency will be more or less?
More.
But in hardware, there is no comparison because this is hardware. When it's hardware, it means there are gates, and all of these comparison will be provided in parallel. Now let's assume if you want to, I will give you an example of a 2-into-1 multiplexer. If you remember last time, I told you that if you want to instantiate a 2-into-1 multiplexer, so a 2-into-1 multiplexer will be something look like this cell. If it's one, out will be assigned the value of A, otherwise out will be assigned the value of B, and now this is your output. If you remember, so what will be inferred in hardware? If you remember, how many AND gates? Two AND gates and one multiplexer. Okay, cell will be here. Now A will be here. A or B? B. And what about A? Now if you look at latency, so let's assume what is the critical path? This one is your critical path. Yes, this is your critical path. So in critical path, let's assume it has a latency of 1 nanosecond. And it is a latency of 1 nanosecond, and it is a latency of 1 nanosecond. What is the latency? 3 nanosecond. So the worst case latency. The worst case latency will be 3 nanosecond. Now, in C, C++, let's assume if I'm saying, like if I'm writing the same statement, so I can write it like this. If cell is equal to 1, out is equal to A, else out is equal to B. Now in this case the latency will be fixed as variable in C. Yeah. So in C or high level language the latency will be variable. But in Verilog some hardware will be formed, some combinational circuit will be formed, and that combinational circuit will have some latency. Yeah. And that latency will be fixed. If I change the order, instead of this, if cell 1 is equal to out A, if I change the order, if cell is equal to 0, out is equal to B, else out is equal to A, what will be inferred in hardware? The same multiplexer. Like if we change the order, the same multiplexer will be inferred. This is very important to consider in C or C++ or in Verilog. This is also one example. Like let's assume if we have some statement in C, I will also explain. And also not only about the latency, but also on the functionality or the correctness. I will explain this with an example. Let's assume that if we say that int C is equal to, let's assume this is your C language, A minus B, int can you think of an example so that the output will be affected if you change the statement? And D is equal to A minus F. Let's assume F, A is a value of 5. D is a value of 2. B is a value of 2. What will be the value of C? 3. So let's assume this C will be 3 equal to. And what will be the value of?
Sir, F
no, okay. I will just think of an example because I have to think of an example. C is equal to A is equal to 5. B is equal to 2. Okay, and F, now we have to define F. Let's assume F is equal to 2 A minus B. So A minus B will be 3, and then not A minus F. So I have to use this D is equal to C minus 4. So what is the value of C? 3. So in this case, C minus, so D, let's assume C minus 2. What will be the value of D? D will be 1. Now we change the order of the statement. If we change the order, instead of if I put D above and C below, no, why do error? I'm not defining it. Just this is just like all of them are defined. All of them are defined. D is equal to C minus 2. What will be the value of D here? Huh? Let's assume we also define C. C is equal to 9. What will be the value of D? 7. D is equal to 7. And what will be the value of C? 3. C is equal to. No, C, but it will be overwritten. When it is defined, it is actually, if you remember it in C, C++, when the value is defined and if you want to update it, so the old value will be overwritten, so the value will be C3. Now, if you look at the opposite, if you change the order, the output is same or different? Different. But in very long, whenever you will do these kind of stuff, so actually the adder or subtractor and it will form an adder or subtractor, so the output will be same in both cases. So that's the reason. Now, the output differ in terms of latency. The latency of two different statements, if you change the order in C, so the latency will be different. And I give this in an example of if and else, if you have some branches. So if the condition is satisfied much earlier, latency will be less in C. And if the condition is satisfied later, the latency will be higher. C is equal to D is equal to C minus 2. What will be the value of D? In the above case, D will be 1. In the lower case, D will be 7. The D is changed. Okay, C is same, but D is changed. So it means that the output is determined by the order in which you are defining it. So the order of the statement in C, C++ affects the output. But in Verilog, it does not affect the output. If you write the same statement, like the same statement, D is equal to C minus 2. So what will be inferred in hardware? In hardware, now we talk in terms of hardware. C is equal to A minus B. Subtracted. C is equal to A minus B. And what about the second statement? C is, then again we have another subtractor. And? So if you change the order, this adder will be same. It will be same. So the order, changing the order of the statements does not affect the
hardware.
And even not does affect the hardware, when the order is same for the both statement, so the output will be same or different?
Same.
The output will be same. So output will be same in terms of functionality, and the output will be, we will get the output after the same latency. And what is that latency? The latency of the critical path.
Yes.
What is the critical path here?
ACD.
This is the critical path.
ACD.
So this is the longest path that we have. Okay. So that's the reason that Verilog is a concurrent language. The order of the state, and also give you an example in the last class lecture that we were instantiating some AND gates and some OR gate. So then I changed order to the same order was formed, if you remember. Okay. Now we start with another level of modeling that is called as behavioral modeling, and in behavioral modeling we are designing the digital system at a higher level of abstraction. So when the complexity of the design is increased, so it's very important to make wise decisions early in the project. Win-win. So we actually we want to design at a very high level of abstraction. Okay. So just forget about all these things. This will be very complex. I'll explain these details later on. But now, how the behavioral, how you can design at a behavioral level level of abstraction. So there are two statements: always plus initial. Always plus initial. So always is a keyword. Okay, always is a keyword. So whenever you see an always statement, so it means which type of model you are using? Behavioral model. Okay, you'll use a behavioral modeling. So each always and initial set. So there are two types of statement in behavioral modeling. Each always and initial statement represent a separate activity flow in Verilog. Each activity flow start at simulation time zero. Both always and simulation initial statement cannot be nested. You cannot use nested always. Okay, always, and then you can have just like in if and else is nested, can be nested. Always cannot be nested. Okay, now first start with the initial statement. Initial statement is used for simulation, if you remember. And we say initial statement, the first statement started simulation time zero. And then if we had hash 5, so it means that the next statement will execute after time 5. And then hash 5 at 10. And then hash 10, 20, and so forth, so on. So initial statement is used in a stimulus block or a design block? Stimulus block. In stimulus block, we are simulating the design or synthesizing the design. We are simulating the design. So the initial statement will be used in the stimulus block. Okay. If you look at the, now, if you have any kind of statement, initial, if you have a single statement, okay, did you see on the left hand side, single statement. So for a single statement, you don't need a begin and end. But if you have multiple statement in initial block, so you need a begin and end. If you remember in C, so you are using curly brackets.
Yes.
If so, actually, if you are using a single statement, you don't need a curly brackets. Yeah. But if you need multiple statements, then you need curly brackets. So in initial block, if you are using multiple statement, how many statements are there?
N
statement. So if you want to combine these multiple statements within initial block, so you need a begin and end. Begins means the start of the initial block, end means the end of the initial block. The same is true for the always block. If you have an always block, if you have a single statement, then no begin and end is required. And if you have multiple statement, so then always begin statement 1, statement 2, statement 3, and so forth, so on, or two statement end, and then end. Now I'll explain this with an example. If you look at the left hand side, so this is an initial block. How many statements are there?
One
statement. So do we need?
No.
Okay. So it means this M is executed at which time instant? Zero. Now we have another initial block. How many statements are there?
Two statements.
So for this reason, we need
begin and
end. At which time this statement? Okay. This initial block two. Now we have three initial blocks. We have three separate initial blocks.
Yes.
This statement A is equal to 1B1, executes at simulation time what? 5. What about this statement? Hash 25, B is equal to 1B0. At simulation time? No, 25, it is 25. So this statement is executed at simulation time 5. 5 plus 25 is equal to?
30.
So this statement executed at simulation time 30. If you look at the other initial block, this statement X is equal to 1B0. 10 and hash 25 y is equal to 1b1 35. So now we have, let's assume now we have module stimulus. What does it, module stimulus implies? Is a simulation stimulus blocks or design blocks?
Stimulus
block. We are simulating a design or we are synthesizing a design?
Simulation
a design, simulating a design. So there are three parallel initial blocks. All of these initial blocks start at the same time. Because now why at the same time? Because Verilog is a concurrent language. When it is a concurrent language, it means multiple statements can execute at the same time.
Yes.
So Verilog, now we have in the module stimulus, we have three initial blocks. With three initial blocks. So the first initial blocks highlighted in purple started simulation time zero. So now we are tracking in terms of time. So when we are talking in terms of time, so what in simulation time zero, which statement will be executed? M is equal to 1B 0. Which block is this? Initial block 1 or 2?
1.
Which statement will be executed in simulation time 5? A is equal to 1B 1. To which block it belongs? Initial block 2. Now simulation time 10. Which statement will execute? X is equal to 1B 0. And to which stimulus block it belongs? To which initial block it belongs?
Third
one. Now, which will be executed at time 30? 30. Which statement will execute? V is equal to 1B 0. And which block?
Second.
And what about the last one? 35. Which statement will execute? No, you can just look at the notes and then you'll see. Okay, so this is stimulus block 3. So it means now this initial block will be invoked each time there is a change in the signal.
Yes.
And now when there is a change in the timing constraint. Okay, so how many times these three initial blocks will be invoked? 5 times. Block 1 will be invoked 1 time. Block 2 is invoked 2 times. And block 3 is invoked 2 times. Okay. So now these are the different time instants and after time. Okay, now if you look, we have 4th initial block, hash 50. So after 50 simulation time, we have finished the simulation. Okay. Now we have 4th initial block. You can combine all of them in the same initial block. You can combine them in the same initial block. You can have one initial block. And all statement, just to give you an example, that now in this particular example, we have 4 simulation block. Now in this case, it will end at simulation time 50 and it will finish the simulation. So it means now, which we can combine all of them in one initial block. You can use one initial block. It's up to you. But just to give you an elaborate that, okay, if there are multiple initial blocks, all of these initial blocks will execute concurrently at the same time. They will start at the same time. And how they proceed, it depends upon the difference in the timing. Okay, now always statement. Initial block is noted. Initial block is always used for simulation. It is not used for synthesis. Now always statement. Always statement can be used both for simulation and it can also be used for synthesis. So now we have an always block. So what is an always block? Always statement constitute an always block. Always block start at simulation time 0. Always start at simulation time 0. Similar to initial block. And execute the statement in the always block continuously in a looping fashion. Continuously in a looping fashion. This statement is used to model a block of activity that is repeated continuously in a digital circuit. Any activity that is repeated, that has a repetition pattern. Which thing has a repeating pattern in digital circuit? For instance, clock. It's repeating. First it is a value of high, then low, then high, then low, and so forth, so on. So it has some repeating or recurring pattern. Okay, now you want to model. If you want to model the clock, so if you look at this module clock generation, we want to generate a clock. And we want to generate this clock for to simulate our design. But we are just modeling the clock. How we can use it? REC clock. I told you REC is why we are defining it as a REC. We can change its value at different time instant. Now, how many blocks we have used in this particular example? Now, initial block. always block. So we have used three blocks. Two initial block, one A, always block. All of them start a simulation time zero. The initial block one, always block, and the initial block two. Okay, now G. क्या? To initialize some value. If we want to simulate our design, so we have to define an instant of time. We have to define an instant of time, so we have to define some time instant 0, time instant 10, time instant 20, and so forth. We are testing our system. If you have any method, please let me know. I will explain this now. Now, what about the always block? If you look at the always block starts simulation time 0. Now, if you look at this statement, hash 10 clock, what we are doing? After each time, we are inverting the clock. So initially, what is the value of clock at time 0? Now we have time 0. Then always block will be invoked at time 10. Because it repeats itself, then at 20, then 30, and so forth, so on until 100. Why 100? Why I have used 100? Because we are finishing the simulation at this time. Okay, let's say so it's 1000. Okay, if 1000, so it's 1000. It's repeating. Why? Now always block will be invoked at simulation time 0. What's the value of clock initially? 0. So this is your clock, and I'm it is 0. It is invoked at 0. Now after time 10, if you look at time 10. After time 10, the clock will be inverted. So if it's 0, so if it is inverted, so it will be the new value of the clock. 1. And after 20? 0. After 30? 0. And then 1. And so forth, so on. It will go. Because now, if you look at this, this always block. Now in this case, always block is triggered here at 0. This is the initial point. And after simulation time 10, This is the delay of 10. After delay of 10 clock cycle, clock is equal to tilde of clock. So it means that now this clock on the left hand side is the new value, and on the right hand side is the old value. What is the old value?
0.
So now this is the old value, and at this point instant it is the new value. Now at this point instant, which one is the old value? This one is the old value, and this one is the new value. Is this the same in C++? If you are assigning a variable, you will write a variable. G.
Sir, this always block. This 10 time instant ke baad fir value change kar raha hai.
Yes. Yes. And then when if I say initial, now we also use the initial block. After 1000 ticks, it will end the simulation. So actually, now when the simulation is invoked, the simulation will be invoked at time t0. Which blocks will be triggered? Three blocks will be triggered. The first initial block, the always block, and the second initial block. But this always block has only a single statement. So it will execute after time 10. Then the always block will be invoked. Now at this time instant, which block will be invoked? This time instant. Always. When? At this point, which block will be invoked? Always. And at 1000, which block will be invoked? Always. Also always. Because it's a multiple of 10. Always will also be invoked. And initial block will be invoked. The third initial block, the last initial block, or the second initial block in this order will be invoked. So always just like an infinite loop. And this always block that I have mentioned, it is used for simulation or for synthesis?
Both.
Now in this particular example, it is used for simulation. Now we will use procedural assignment. Procedural assignment is always used in the always block. So there are, okay, now we also already studied continuous assignment. Continuous assignment was used in data flow modeling. प्रोसीजर असाइनमेंट इज यूज इन विच मॉडलिंग बिहेवियरल मॉडलिंग सो इन बिहेवियरल मॉडलिंग इफ यू आर यूजिंग सो इन बिहेवियरल मॉडल विच स्टेटमेंट विल बी यूज ऑलवेज ऑलवेज ब्लॉक कीवर्ड द कीवर्ड यूज विल बी ऑलवेज इन कंटिन्यूस असाइनमेंट व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द कीवर्ड असाइन सो देयर आर सम रूल्स फॉर द कंटिन्यूस असाइनमेंट सो देयर आर ऑल्सो सम रूल्स फॉर द प्रोसीजर असाइनमेंट जी so now I'll explain it okay so now I'll explain it okay so if you are using procedure assignment so the procedure assignment always update a value of rec integer real or time variable value proceed on a variable will remain unchanged until another procedure assignment value is assigned so we have a left value l value left value and an expression on the right hand side now what should be the rule for the LHS so the left hand side of the procedure assignment can be a rect data type can be integer real or time variable it cannot be a net the left hand side of the procedure assignment cannot be net but what was the condition for the continuous assignment if you remember it was the left hand side must be net the right hand side can be rect or net but in to a bit select of these variable it can be a bit select it can be a part select or it can be a concatenation the left hand side now how the always block will look like for the synthesis related so always block will look like this always at is the keyword always at begin and end why we have used begin and end because we have multi statements and then there is an event list I will explain this how this event list is looks like this statement is always only activated when signals in the event list changes so we can specify some signals in the event list I will explain this with an example so now always it what is this this is your keyword what does it implies which assignment procedure assignment procedure assignment okay now a or b what is a or b no if you look at here event list it is an event list so the statement is only activated when signals in the event list changes which signals are mentioned in the event list a so this statement will be invoked when a changes or b changes with a changes or b changes and if you look at this left hand side if this left hand side c it should be reg or net it must be reg what about right hand side it can be reg or net doesn't matter it can be a bit select it can be a part select or it can be g
sir is statement kya likhi hui hai